Yeah, whoa.
Oh. Apparently Miss Muffet also wants some color. Hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I am going to play with Halloweeny stuff from Makeup Revolution. I have Corpse Bride here. I have a Jack Skeleton highlighter. I have a lippy. I have me, because I'm the most spooky of them all. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you love to be inspired, or to just have fun, see some unusual color combinations, a little bit of quirkiness thrown in the mix. I try to be normal, but I usually fail miserably. Then this is the channel for you, and if you subscribe now, you will be entered in our Halloween event. Yes, this should go up the week before Halloween, and if it is after Halloween, then it is at least in time for Halloween next year. So, never mind. But our Halloween event yet consists of everything. We have
hobbits, we have zombies, we have uncooked chickens, we have slightly orcish like me, which is basically Olive. We have Oompa Loompas, we have a lot.
Oh yes, we also need pyrotechnics and dancers, just so you know. It does not really matter what your skill is, you are welcome, because we need everyone to join. And if it is after Halloween, we are still a band, but then we're the Nightmare Before Christmas band. And after Christmas, I will figure it out when we get there. Yes. Today, however, a lot of Makeup Revolution. I have, as you see, already done part of my face, kind of to save time a little bit, but it is actually all with Makeup Revolution. So let me just go over quickly what I use. Didn't use face primer. I use my Revolution Perfect CC Cream in 5.7 that I darkened up a hint with my Woma foundation in Honey Honey Tea, the lightest of the honey. I don't remember. Then fake freckles are from Shane. Everything will be listed down below as well, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, freckle tint is from Shane. I have a concealer from Makeup Revolution. I have a blush from Makeup Obsession that I have on my face. That is the shade Dune Rust. But please don't be fooled by the color on the outer packaging, because the color of the outer packaging is not the same as the product, which is kind of weird. But yeah, what can you do about it? I think that was kind of it, right? Oh yeah, setting powder is also for Makeup Revolution. It's their Hydra Fix. I'm going to do powder blush and then powder highlight. For powder blush, I'm grabbing the X Revolution in the shade Entice. I really like their blushes. Their highlighters are very good as well. From X Revolution, just so you know. But it will just enhance a little bit of the blush that I already have. And I also love me a little bit of blush draping. Just a hint. Okay. I have already primed my eyes as well with the Natasha Denona base, because I don't have a Makeup Revolution eye primer. I'm going to use this one, the Jack Skeleton. I thought it was in stock and I thought it's just so cute. See, I did not really want the eyeshadow palette. I thought, let me just get this, because I felt it was cute. Can I open it? Not with my claws, but how am I going to remove the plasticky people? Apparently with my claw. Thank you. So here it is. It has his face on it. There are two, but this one, I think the other one was very icy, and that's not what I go for. So let me get a brush. Here. But I prefer a highlighter that is technically too dark for me, or at least that's what they say. I think it's very, very pretty. I think that I could build it up if I wanted to, but then it is a little bit too icy for what I like. So what I do then is I grab my blush brush again and I just buff it in. I also love, if you have a highlighter that's maybe a tad too icy for you, what I also love to do is then put it underneath the blush, because that's very pretty as well. I also have a lippy. I don't really know if it will go with the makeup look, but we're going to use it anyway. Can I open it up? Oh Lord. I should have come prepared. So the lippy that I got is also from the Corpse Bride line, and I have the shade Victor. The outer box, it's just too cute. I love stuff like this. And here's the component. Looks very pretty. Looks very pretty. It feels nice, and it's plastic, and it feels nice and sturdy. It doesn't feel luxurious though. Just saying. But then again, it's Makeup Revolution, and there are not a lot of things that they make that feel luxurious. Although I have to say that these, they're better. Oh yes, lip liner. Let me do a lip liner, and I have one from, I love the plumping liners from Catrice, but they also have a clear one, so let's try that one. I actually do have lip liners from Makeup Revolution, I'm just remembering. It's a nice, what is it? Is it a peachy color? Something, I need to do it correctly. Something like that. It's not an extremely opaque lippy, I feel. But I do like the color. Maybe it's a little bit of more of a satin formula. I don't know. But we're keeping it on today. The eyeshadow palette I'm going to use today is this one from the Corpse Bride. I did not really want a bigger one. And I just felt that the artwork of this was very, very cool. I also like the color story. This is the color story. Smaller pans, but that's okay. I like it. So yeah, I'm going to use that one today. I already have something in mind. I hope at least. You never know with me. Okay, what I want to do, well, I don't have a lot of matte options. I have a bunch of purples. I'm going to do purple today. I'm going to do a purple crease. And I kind of have an idea for the shimmers, but we will see. I'm not going to swatch because I don't feel like it. And the pans are tiny. I don't want to dig my claws in. Yeah, that's it. Okay, let's start with the shade called so basically there are bluer purples in here and some pinker purples. I'm going to focus on the bluer purples today. I'm going to start with the shade Dreams, which is kind of the same idea as my shirt. I'm going to zoom you in as well. Hello, up close and personal. A hint of kick up in the pan, not a lot. Let's just tap this on. Yeah, this is like a pastel. I'm really building it up. If you want a shadow like this to pop, you need to use an as light as base, and preferably a white base. And a tacky one. Now my base is still tacky. And I am using a slightly fluffier brush, but let's go to the shade Beautiful, this one. These two look so similar. There's a slight undertone difference, but that's it. So the one that I'm grabbing now is a darker bluer purple, and the shade Different is a little bit more pink in it. Let's see what this does. This one is more pigmented than the lighter one that I'm going to go back to now, the shade Dreams, to blend out this shade a little bit more. I'm going to a smaller brush. It's still a fluffy brush, but I'll pick up a little bit better with this one. Back to the shade Dreams. There's not very, very deep shade in the palette. The other one that I'm looking at is, it's not darker than this one. This is the darkest one that there is. But I can still create a nice amount of darkness with this one. Okay, I am grabbing a glitter primer on the back of my hand, and I'm tapping it on my lower lash line. A Then I'm going to go to the shade Promise. And I'm going to press that on top. And somewhere in the outer corner, I want that shade as well to help connect it to the bottom. I have kind of a blurple eye pencil. This is from Kiko and it's a purple, but it's a very blue tone purple. I'm going to go to the shade Beautiful, which is the darker purple. A little bit more in on my lid. And then I'm going to go to the shade Dreams, which was the first shade. So I have the base down. Okay, now I'm going to grab a little bit more of the shimmers. I'm going to go back to that shade Promise, the darker bluer purple. Am I creating fallout? Yes, a lot. Because I'm using it dry with a somewhat fluffier brush. I'm going to go next to the shade Heartbreak. I have a sponge tip here just because, I don't know, it's easier. This is more along the lines of a topper shade. And you can see that it really picks up on the base that it has underneath, which is very, very cool. Next I'm going to go to the shade Always. And I just wipe my sponge tip on the towel that I have here. This is a very, it's almost, I don't know, a lavendery silver or something? I have no idea. It's pretty. I'm also going to go to the shade Spirit, which is the shiny white. And I'm just going to dust this over a little bit in the beginning. Basically like a dry brush. That's what I'm doing now. And then I kind of wanted to have a little bit of something extra, as I usually do. So I'm going to go to the shade Eternal Love. It's going to go in the inner corner. Unfortunately for me, my face kind of eats up greens like this. But it is still something, I don't know, almost spooky. So let me clean everything up. Put on lashes, liner. And I want to say lippy, but I already have a lippy on. And then I will come back and show you the final look and give you my opinion on the stuff that I used today. I like how it turned out. I need more of these falsies because I love them so much. They're the Style Jean from AOA Studio, from Shop Miss A. And that's basically, yeah, and I put in earrings. These are from Love Kills Boutique though. One of the few that I didn't make myself. Yeah, I really like how the look came together. Let me kind of go over everything that I used from the collection. So I used the highlighter and the lippy. The lippy, it's almost like, it does transfer, but it is almost, I don't really know. Is it a matte? Or maybe a satin. I feel like I need to work for it a little bit more to get the color that I want. However, I did not use a colored lip liner underneath. You saw that. And I also had a little bit of lip mask on my lip still. So maybe that is it. I do really like the color though. And I think that the formula feels comfortable. It looks pretty. Yes, so far I like it. And I had the shade Victor. And the reason that I got the shade Victor is because it was the most orangey of the three. Yes. Then the highlighter. Yeah, I like Makeup Revolution's highlighter formula, usually. And this one doesn't disappoint me either. Will I use it a ton? Probably not. But I do really, really like it. So this will not be in my highlighter drawer. This will just be somewhere where I can see it. And that is why I bought it, honestly. It is nice enough to use, though. So if you want this one because you really want to use it, I don't think that you will be disappointed. Unless you go for a very, very blinding highlighter. But still, I think that you can really nicely build this up. I think that if you spray your brush, so pick up highlighter, spray your brush, and then kind of go on your face, or spray your face and then put on highlighter. I think you can make it very blinding and intense. It is not a glittery highlighter, which I like. I like highlighters that have a smooth formula, like this one. And I think it's very, very pretty. So yeah, definitely a win in my book. Let's go then next to the eyeshadow palette. It is as I expected. I know that their formula can be a little bit hit or miss. Usually I can make a lot of things work though. What I did notice, and that is not really weird either, is this shade that I started with. It needs a base that is sticky. And it needs a base that is as light as you can get away with for it to show up. Hello, my dear. So it's good that we're in a Halloween-y video then. You know, if you lick my face, you lick the makeup off, right? I think that it's sticky base light. Yeah, I think it will be the same with this shade and maybe even with the blue as well. But because usually, or at least I am not blue and I'm not pink, they will show up a little bit better. I'm not
slightly orcish.
Yes, I know.
The merch coming out? We want slightly orcish merch.
Yeah, I need to have time to make it, yes. I'm not purpley either, but it is in the palette matte wise I think the lightest, looking at the camera or the viewfinder and then to this palette. I am very much liking the depth that I could create with it though. If you are pasty pale, you can make everything work. If you are tan, I think you will need a lighter base. Yeah, but the mattes blended very, very well and they layered very nicely. Granted, I only used two shades, but I did layer this one on top of the lighter one and then on top of itself as well. So I could keep on layering it and it is not turning patchy. So that is very, very nice. The shimmers that are in here are pretty. This one is more along the lines of a topper, but it also has a shift because I can see a peach, I can see a blue. It's a very, very interesting shade. Yeah, I did not use a lot of this palette. I was not going to. I just wanted to try it, and purples are usually hard to formulate, and these purples were actually very nice to work with. So yeah, I think that's it. I think that if you like this palette, I don't feel it's a dud. Let me just say that. I don't feel that I needed to work very, very hard for it. I needed to build up the lightest shade, yes, but that's not really weird. And yeah, I don't know. I think it's nice. It's not a dud. So yeah, I'm happy that I got it. Let me know down below your thoughts. Have you gotten this? Were you eyeing this? Does my review help? Let me know down below. I don't know if it will crease on me. I don't think it will, honestly. But if I don't forget, I will leave it in a pinned comment or maybe even put it on the screen because we are having shitty weather today. So yeah, if there is any time for creasing, it's basically right now. So yes, I will keep on trying out. I don't think that I will try out the palette more. I don't know if I will have the time. So basically, yes, this is a first impression, but it's also the review. I will mention it again in the Best of Beauty and I will basically place it in a tier and give some additional thoughts. And then that's going to be it for today. Yes. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you super soon in my next one. Bye, guys.